칙칙TV와 함께하는 이지앤 이지 한국어. 칙칙!
How do we say 가고 있어요 in Korean?
어디에요? 가고 있어요. Have you ever heard of I'm coming in English conversation? How do we say I'm coming in Korean? We say 가고 있어요. By the way, in Korean, 오다 means come and 가다 means go. Then shouldn't you say 오고 있어요, not 가고 있어요? When do you say 가고 있어요 and 오고 있어요? In Korean, we always put ourselves in the speaker's shoes and say it. Based on the speaker, if the subject of the action is going, we say 가고 있어요. And if the subject of the action is coming, we say 오고 있어요. Let's find the difference out in some examples. Example 1. 어디에요? 가고 있어요. In this situation, both the speaker and the subject of the action are B. From the B's point of view, B is not coming to A, but going to A. So B should say 가고 있어요, not 오고 있어요. Let's try another example. B는 지금 어디래요? 오고 있대요. In this situation, the speaker is A and the subject of the action is B. From the A's point of view, B is not going but coming. So A should say 오고 있대요, not 가고 있대요. Now let's compare three similar examples. Example 3. 어제 혹시 서울 갔었어요?
네, 어제 거기 갔었어요. 어제 혹시 서울 갔었어요?
From the A's point of view, the speaker is A and the subject of the action is B. A mentioned 갔었어요, not 왔었어요. From A saying, we can assume that A stays away from Seoul.
네, 어제 거기 갔었어요.
From the B's point of view, both the speaker and the subject of the action are B himself. So B should say 갔었어요, not 왔었어요. Also, we can assume that B is not in Seoul currently from his saying. Example 4.
어제 혹시 서울 왔었어요?
네, 어제 거기 갔었어요. 어제 혹시 서울 왔었어요?
From the A's point of view, the speaker is A and the subject of the action is B. From A's saying, we can assume that A stays in Seoul.
네, 어제 거기 갔었어요.
The rule is same as example 3. Example 5.
방학 때 혹시 서울 왔었어요?
네, 방학 때 여기 왔었어요.
방학 때 혹시 서울 왔었어요?
The rule is same as example 4.
네, 방학 때 여기 왔었어요.
In this situation, both the speaker and the subject of the action are B. From B's saying, we can assume that B was in Seoul on his last vacation and he's currently in Seoul as well.
That's all for today. 다음에 또 만나요. 안녕. Bye.